Shortly after Australia joined the war effort in Europe, the RAAF found itself in desperate need of skilled labour at home. A shortage of men would lead to the formation of the Women's Auxiliary Australian Air Force in 1941. And by the end of the war, women filled many traditionally male-dominated roles. While some women wanted to serve their country, for others, the war was a way to escape conservative Australian society. Norma May Hornby enlisted on the 28th of September 1942 at the No. 2 Recruiting Centre in Sydney, New South Wales.
When Mum turned 18, she decided to enlist in the WAAAF because she was looking for some excitement and, I think, some independence.
As a clerk for an accountant, Norma was well suited to working in signals. After basic training, she was posted to Melbourne Wireless Transmitting Station, or Frognall, on the 25th of November 1942. For much of the war, Frognall was headquarters to the RAAF Signals Unit, and although men worked on site, only WAAFs lived in huts built on the grounds. Life at Frognall was busy. In 8-hour shifts, women worked around the clock. Signals were received in code, deciphered, and then dispatched or retransmitted to units across the region. Although the WAAFs had certain freedoms, life at Frognall was highly regimented. But Norma and her friends found ways to bend the rules.
If they had got a leave pass and it was approved, they had to wear their uniform. If they wanted to go out in civvies, they would sneak out through the back fence.
And it was on one of these outings that Norma met Edward George Garth, or Ted.
Dad was with three colleagues and Mum was with three friends. And the RAAF asked the WAAFs to go out with them. And the girls said no. And there was a gentleman who looked at them and said, "Girls, there's four of you and there's four of them. It's perfect." And that's where their friendship started.
But shortly after they met, Ted was posted to the Northern Territory. Edward George Garth had been a corporal in the Air Training Corps at age 16. At age 18, he enlisted in the RAAF in the hope of becoming a wireless operator.
Dad lived in an abusive household. The opportunity to enlist was something he really looked forward to.
Over the next 2 years, he was based at Cummerley Creek, Burdham and Bachelor.
Dad found Mum a very gentle and kind person. He asked Mum to write to him, which she did.
During this time, Ted and Norma got to know each other through letters. While many of the signals that passed through Frognall dealt with the mundane business of war, everything was classified.
Towards the end of Mum's service, she took a message from London that said that peace had been declared. She was so excited. She told all the girls and they all laughed and screamed and shouted for joy. Mum did not tell that story to us until quite recently. She was sworn to secrecy. I decided that it needed to be told. When I asked her, she was adamant that she had been to the Royal Exhibition Buildings during the war.
Have you got the photo of going to AWL? What's a photo of us sneaking in civvies.
Oh, yes, out the back fence, yes.
With bands, concerts and dances for servicemen and women throughout the war, it's not hard to imagine Norma and her friends on an outing to the Palais Royale at the Exhibition Building.
Mum has just this July turned 96. She's looked upon the years she spent at Frognall very fondly.
And another night we came in late and the people on one side had a wood heap that went up against the fence and that's how we got in.
Some 27,000 women served in the Women's Auxiliary Australian Air Force and many, like Norma, considered it one of the highlights of their lives.